Waging War on Corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Second hour of the Alex Jones Show live, final segment here with David Knight. There was a story which went up a couple of days ago. FBI chief, citizens should be deeply skeptical of government. Americans should be deeply skeptical of government power, says FBI Director James Comey, adding that law enforcement should be able to access someone's telephone only with a court order. Now, this is a guy who back during the initial NSA surveillance scandal back in January 2006, when, of course, it came out in the New York Times that the Bush administration was overseeing a lot of these programs. He put a block in place which prevented the NSA from really hammering down on the full, complete panopticon surveillance of the American people. So he's been an individual who has set himself against surveillance since as far back as 2006, and now he's saying that Americans should be deeply skeptical of government. Of course, under the DHS's definitions, that probably makes him a terrorist. Remember the 2011 study, university study funded by the DHS, which said, quote, liberty lovers were in league with terrorists. Well, now the FBI director is voicing similar rhetoric. But David Knight, his point about surveillance as it relates to the iPhone, to cell phones in general, you say that he's contradicting himself.
Yeah, I think people should be deeply skeptical of his statements linking himself with the founders. I hope he's sincere about that. But then he goes on to say that he has a real problem with what Apple and Google are doing. He says, if you're going to block that, that's like creating a car with a trunk that I can never open, even if I get a court order. Now, he's saying that for this to be done legally, people need to go to a judge and get a court order to show what they want to search for. And of course, we all know that. We also all know that the government hasn't done that for a very long time. And nothing has been done to the people who have violated that law. So as FBI director, I would ask him, if you're going to tell us that we have a constitution in place that is checks and balances that prohibits this, then where are you when we have government officials violating their oath to the Constitution and searching without warrants? If he wants to start enforcing that, then we can talk about the rest of this stuff. But quite frankly, when the government disobeys the law, I think we should be deeply skeptical of somebody who starts quoting the founding fathers and doesn't do anything to enforce the Constitution. The way this is going to go, Paul, is that what we're seeing, if it even works, I'm not sure at this point, I'm deeply distrustful of the technology companies as well, but if Apple and Google's strategy really is secure, they're doing that as a PR stunt because they have to sell their products internationally. And internationally, people don't want the United States government looking at them either. However, the internet service providers and the cell phone providers that are here in this country, they are captive to the government. They're dependent on the government for their entire business. They have to do everything the government tells them to do. Even if your phone is secure, the minute you're sending or receiving information to your internet service provider or your cell phone company, the government has a jack right there at that point. They're going to intercept it. They're going to store it at that point. So a lot of this is a smokescreen. But if he wants to talk about courts, let's talk about the FISA court. The FISA court was set up to stop the NSA from spying on American citizens, and yet it's not a court by any means. This is nothing more than a star chamber proceedings where you have one judge and one person from the government telling the judge what they want. He rubber stamps it. There's no adversarial argument made from the other people. The other side, there is no jury. There's nothing. Just a single judge and a government official coming in and saying, I want you to do this. And he says, in almost all cases, yes. I don't know if there's any cases. They have a record where they were turned down. The FISA court gives them anything that they want, any way that they want to surveil the American people.
And again, it's, you know, whether people still care about surveillance, you know, if you've got nothing to hide, well, you know, give me your email password, give me the access to your bank account. They tend to get very reticent to hand over that information if you phrase it in that way, and yet they're quite happy to have the convenience of the iPhone and give away all their secrets to NSA surveillance, which is a subject we're going to cover with Wayne Madsen after the break. Stay tuned, Infowars.com.
Alex Jones here to tell you about how you can help spread liberty worldwide while also enjoying what I have found to be the best tasting 100% organic coffee on the planet. For more than a decade, my favorite coffee has come from the high mountains of southern Mexico, where the Chiapas farmers grow their unique shade-grown Arabica beans. We have now managed to secure these sought-after beans in a highly customized blend. Discover and try a bag of the Patriot Blend 100% organic coffee at InfoWarsLife.com. This coffee gives you a long, smooth pick-me-up for hours without the headaches and heartburn that so many other coffees give me personally. Hands down, this is my favorite coffee. And it's taken us years to secure connections directly to the Chiapas Mexican farmers. Drop by the site today, order a bag or two, and I don't think you're going to be disappointed. Available in original or with our immune support infusion blend, you will be supporting a free press, all the while enjoying a truly great-tasting cup of my favorite coffee. Available at InfoWarsLife.com.
When cells become toxic, they die early and aging sets in. No one has put together a formula that focuses directly on brain health, nerve growth factors, and optimizing your cellular energy at the same time. Just one of the key compounds, BioPQQ, is backed by major clinical studies. You want the best that's out there at the lowest price anywhere? We now have the synergistic solution. Secure your DNA force today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel body armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel body armor just won't quit.
Using unparalleled research in the development of a synergistic formulation based around the key concepts of superoxygenation, the next level in cleansing is here. With key ingredients backed by real clinical studies, the new Oxy Powder, available through InfoWars Life, was invented during Dr. Group's research on the toxification of our bodies. Many herbal colon cleansers are harsh on the body and contain cheap and potentially dangerous ingredients, oftentimes full of synthetic fillers, GMOs, additives, or worse. Gently start cleaning your body with easy capsules that start working while you sleep. Oxy Powder does not require time off work, and there's no need for bad-tasting concoctions. Instead, Oxy Powder slowly releases monoatomic oxygen into the intestinal tract and body. Experience the astonishing cleansing power of superoxide and ozonide technology. Go to InfoWarsLife.com or InfoWarsStore.com to get started with Oxy Powder, or call 1-888-253-3139.
From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
So the Alex Jones Show live with me, Paul Joseph Watson. We're going to go to your calls for Wayne Madsen at the bottom of the hour, 1-800-259-9231. But we're joined by Wayne Madsen, of course, NSA whistleblower and investigative journalist, to discuss ISIS and a whole host more. Wayne Madsen, welcome to the show.
Hi, good to be with you, Paul.
Thanks for being here. First off, I mean, we're going to get into ISIS soon. I wanted to get your quick take. I don't know how closely you've been following it. On the Ebola outbreak, of course, because we've had this botched response from the CDC, it seems, the first two cases there in Dallas. Do you think that this is merely incompetence on behalf of the public health authorities, or are we seeing some kind of deliberate malfeasance?
Well, I just returned from a conference in Tehran last week, and of course, Tehran, in my mind, was going to be a great place to find out all about ISIL or ISIS or whatever you want to call this group. But I actually discovered some things about Ebola while I was there, which I didn't think I would in that particular venue. First of all, one of my colleagues, Dr. Randy Short, produced a patent for the Ebola virus from the U.S. Patent and Trademark Office. It was patented a few years ago, has a barcode on it. It's a government document. That was a little bit surprising. But what was even more surprising is when I took a tour through the former torture chambers of the dreaded Shah's secret police, the SAVAK, and discovered that the head of that particular unit, a guy named Parvez Sabati, has been living here in the United States for over 30 years in Orlando, operating a business out of a P.O. box and out of private residences. And his daughter, who serves on his board for one of these companies that doesn't have a real address, it turns out that she was responsible at Harvard. She's a Harvard biologist for mapping the Ebola virus from an animal gene pool to the human gene pool. Now, you know, you put the patent together with that kind of information. You know, here's somebody whose father was a brutal torturer, and you have to wonder what is behind this sudden outbreak of Ebola, which we had an outbreak in Zaire. It's actually called the Zaire Ebola virus some years ago, but it was eradicated in Zaire, now Congo, Democratic Republic of Congo. How come it all of a sudden appears in these three West African countries that have been rife with civil wars and coup d'etats brought about mostly by countries that are after their natural resources, gold, diamonds, and iron, and of course, Israel figures very big in that operation. They've been responsible for an attempt to overthrow the government of Guinea, and they were involved in supplying both sides in the very bloody civil wars in both Liberia and Sierra Leone. I'm very suspicious about Ebola, and especially where we saw the outbreak in the hot zones right now in those three countries.
Let's turn to ISIS then, because over the weekend we had ISIS almost taking the town of Kobani in Syria. They're making advances in western Baghdad. I mean, the U.S. offensive against ISIS, the airstrikes, only seem to have bolstered ISIS. Now they're expanding their spread throughout the region. Isn't that the case?
Yeah, and, you know, who is this ISIS? I spoke to Islamic scholars in Tehran who said this group has no absolutely nothing to do with Islam. It has a lot to do, of course, with Saudi Arabia, which practices a very heretical form of Islam known as Wahhabism. They, on the other hand, look at any other Islamic sect, whether Shia, Sufis, or even other Sunni sects as apostates and heretics. But this Wahhabist sect was born out of the British Foreign Office during the Ottoman reign. It's not real Islam. And then you look at ISIL, you look at the fact that there's 12,000 foreign mercenaries from 81 different countries, including the United States, Canada, and many in Western Europe, who have no affiliation through marriage or family or anything with Islam. And you have to wonder, What is ISIL? Is this actually the implementation of something known as the Yenon Plan, formulated in 1982 by an Israeli journalist named Oded Yenon, which talked about breaking apart the other Arab countries surrounding Israel into warring factions? And that's exactly what we're seeing today in Syria and Iraq. And look who's been promoting these rebels. Neocons like John McCain and the other neocons in the State Department, the same people who brought about the total destruction of Iraq as a nation. That's who's behind ISIL. And then you look at these demonstrations against Africans in Tel Aviv and other parts of Israel and by these right-wing settlers, and they're all wearing ISIL T-shirts and waving the ISIL flag. They even found a bag of ISIL flags. Some gardeners found a bag of ISIL flags, brand new flags that had fallen off a truck in northern Israel. I would suggest that ISIL is an operation that was formulated by the U.S., CIA, the Mossad, and Saudi intelligence in the person of Prince Bandar. And we know how dirty he is, especially His name's all over those missing 28 pages from that Senate, Joint Senate.